Welcome. We continue with our novena for the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. Today, on our 8th day, Friday, 7th week of Easter, we will think about the gift of wisdom. Bend the stubborn heart and will, melt the frozen warm, the chill, guide the steps that go astray. The gift of wisdom. Embodying all the other gifts, as charity embraces all the other virtues, wisdom is the most perfect of the gifts. Of wisdom it is written, all good things come to me with her and innumerable riches through her hands. It is the gift of wisdom that strengthens our faith, fortifies hope, and perfects charity, and promotes the practice of virtue the highest degree. Wisdom enlightens the mind to discern and relish things divine, in the appreciation of which earthly joys lose their savor, whilst the cross of Christ yields a divine sweetness according to the words of the Savior. Take up thy cross and follow me, for my yoke is sweet, and my burden is light. The gift of wisdom, if you remember from the Old Testament, it is the only gift that Solomon requests from God. He rejects richness, power. He requests from God only wisdom. Wisdom is totally different than knowledge. Knowledge is something that we get, of course, with the help of books, technology, internet, history, science. That's knowledge. But wisdom is something that we apply. It's something that we call it in the colloquial word, the school of life. The wisdom from your grandpa, your grandma. The little counsel that somebody told you, be careful with these kind of situations. Don't treat the other people in that way. What is God telling you? That's wisdom. When we try to think about wisdom, it's something that we need to discern every single day and in our actions. God, give me the wisdom. There are prayers in our Catholic background that we use that kind of request. God, give me the wisdom for discernment. God, give me the wisdom to know your will.
peace and cling to love, and teach me humbly to receive the sun and rain of your sovereignty. Each strand of sorrow has a place within this tapestry. Perfect will in your perfect way. Each strand of sorrow has a place within this tapestry of grace. So through the trials I choose to say your perfect will in your perfect way.
Let us pray. Come, O Spirit of wisdom, and reveal to my soul the mysteries of heavenly things, their exceeding greatness, power, and beauty. Teach me to love them above and beyond all the passing joys and satisfactions of earth. Help me to attain them and possess them forever. Amen.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Act of consecration to the Holy Spirit. On my knees, I, before the great multitude of heavenly witnesses, I offer myself, soul, and body to you, Eternal Spirit of God. I adore the brightness of your purity, the unerring keenness of your justice, and the might of your love. You are the strength and light of my soul. In you I live and move and am. I desire never to grieve you by unfaithfulness to grace, and I pray with all my heart to be kept from the smallest sin against you. Mercifully guard my every thought, and grant that I may always watch for your light, and listen to your voice, and follow your gracious inspirations. I cling to you, and give myself to you, and ask you, by your compassion, to watch over me in my weakness. Holding the pierced feet of Jesus and looking at his 5 wounds and trusting in his precious blood and adoring his opened side and stricken heart, I implore you, adorable Spirit, helper of my infirmity, to keep me in your grace, that I may never sin against you. Give me grace, O Holy Spirit, Spirit of the Father and the Son, to say to you always and everywhere, Speak, Lord, for your servant heareth. Amen. Prayer for the 7 gifts of the Holy Spirit. O Lord Jesus Christ, who before ascending into heaven did promise to send the Holy Spirit to finish your work in the souls of your apostles and disciples, deign to grant the same Holy Spirit to me, that he may perfect in my soul the work of your grace and your love. Grant me the spirit of wisdom, that I may despise the perishable things of this world and aspire only after the things that are eternal. The spirit of understanding, to enlighten my mind with the light of your divine truth. The spirit on counsel, that I may ever choose the surest way of pleasing God and gaining heaven. The spirit of fortitude, that I may bear my cross with you, and that I may overcome with courage all the obstacles that oppose my salvation. The spirit of knowledge, that I may know God and know myself and grow perfect in the signs of the saints. The spirit of piety, that I may find the service of God sweet and amiable, and the spirit of fear, that I may be filled with a loving reverence towards God, and may dread in any way to displease him. Mark me, dear Lord, with a sign of your true disciples, and animate me in all things with your spirit. Amen.